spiritual life on this earth, Supreme Master Ching Hai teaches us the highest method, the Kuan Yin method, which will enable our souls to be liberated from the cycle of birth and death. And in our daily life, Supreme Master Ching Hai reminds us to live a meaningful saint's life in purity and compassion. She shares with us the art of cooking vegetarian cuisine so that we may bring a warm and loving atmosphere to our families and friends. Vegetarian cuisine is not only nutritious, but also helps our consciousness to be in harmony with nature and filled with love for all beings in the universe.
Si nous voulons apporter le paradis sur la terre, nous devons vivre comme les êtres du paradis. C'est-à-dire vivre dans une fraction harmonieuse en respectant la liberté et le droit de vivre de chacun. Les cinq préceptes et le régime végétarien ne sont pas vraiment obligatoires. Il s'agit seulement d'un style de vie juste et noble, celui d'un gentleman, d'un sage possédant compassion et grandeur, et dont l'amour inclut toutes les créatures. Étant l'être le plus élevé de toute la création, nous pouvons distribuer cette grâce en préservant la vie dans le monde où nous vivons. Et cela vraiment contribue à la paix sur la terre. C'est cela l'amour, la gentillesse en action.
Supreme Master Ching Hai encourages and promotes vegetarianism as the noble way of living. She personally designed the Alternative Living Flyer and launched a global campaign to share this peaceful and loving message to the world.
If we want to truly lead a life of love thy neighbor, the neighbors, including our animal friends, especially they harm us in no way. They only beautify our life, and they are loving, and they make our life more lively, colorful, and interesting. We should preserve them, watch them, love them, enjoy their presence. God has made it clear. He said, I made all the animals to befriend you and help you.
Through her teachings, millions of people have become vegetarians or are changing their ways of thinking in regards to the sentient nature of our animal friends. With heartfelt gratitude, we sincerely thank Supreme Master Ching Hai for setting aside her precious time to share with us these wonderful vegetarian dishes and easy cooking tips. We invite you to join us on Between Master and Disciples for this two-part program of A Gift of Love, Simple and Nutritious Cooking with Supreme Master Ching Hai, featuring Cocoa Delight and Exotic Avocado Salad.
All right, kiddo, we're gonna do some fantastic cooking today. Yes. Okay, this is called vegan spare rib. But you don't have to call it spare rib even. Yes, you can call it some fanciful food. You know? Like fragrant coconut. Yes, something more to your liking. Savory coconut, oh, angel blessing coconut, blessed coconut, blissful coconut, yeah, cozy coconut, whatever you like, okay? The reason we call it vegan spirits, so that the people, who, if they still just transit to vegetarian diet, and they still feel like to replace in their psychological mind something similar to what they've been eating, then you can call that vegan spirit, okay? For that we need 200 grams of gluten powder. Gluten flour or powder, completely, it's just gluten, is gleaned from wheat flour. And then we have dry coconut, it's already shell, yeah, and only the flesh is ready. And for the sauce, we will have one orange and a few strawberries, fresh. And for spicing, we have coriander powder, seed powder, black pepper, ground it, but not powdery, okay? Ground it, but you still can see the little grain. And some salt, and vegetarian stir-fry sauce. Sometimes they call it vegetarian oyster sauce. Yeah, okay. It's made from mushroom and soy sauce. And we need some soy milk. And for side dish, for accompanying dish, we have some zucchini and cherry tomatoes. And for salad, we have two avocados, medium size, or bigger size. These are bio products. These are from organic products, from the organic farm, and some are from my own garden. Okay, let's begin. Okay, now we're going to slice this coconut into small pieces, like finger size, yeah? A little bit thinner than that. There we are. We cut them into long kind of stick. Something like this, huh? See, a little thinner than your finger width. Like that. It doesn't matter so much, yes. But if it's thinner, it just cooks nice. And it looks more like the effect that you want. For a more better looking effect, you can shell away the brown protective layer of the coconut so it becomes completely white. But that is not a necessary thing, okay? Right. Okay, then it becomes white like this. You can shell it beforehand, before you slice them, or you can shell after. If you want to shell the brown part. See the brown part that protects the coconut flesh outside? Not the thick skin, it's just the brown protective layer, very thin layer inside. After you take away the skin, the hull of the coconut. If you want to shell the protective brown layer, after you slice it, then you have to be careful that it will not break. Okay, be gentle with it. We shall call this Cocoa Delight, eh? Cocoa Delight is a nice name, I like it. You see, the advantage of shelling after you slice is that you can put it on the board and just, you know, skin it away a little part at a time, like this, and it will not break. And also easier than when you shell the whole shell before you slice. Yeah? That's easier. Got it? You see, the broken part and the skin, you don't throw away in the garbage, huh? You can put it outside for the rat. Yeah, and some birds, they eat them. At least the rat will eat them. Okay? You see, for the hard shell outside, you have to use a hammer to break it gently around. And then all the hard shell will fall apart and you just peel them off. So it remains the soft flesh inside the coconut. You see, this is how the coconut look like. Well, we have not broken the shell yet, see? When you use a hammer to knock it around, yes, gently, you know, maybe make one horizontal and then one vertical or something like that. Just break the shell only, yes? So you can try to get the coconut as whole as possible so that you can have the length that you want. If the flesh inside broken to small pieces, then you cannot use the length that you want. That's all. But it's still okay. Okay, this is a kind of a big coconut, na? So I think I use 300 gram of gluten flour, gluten powder, soy milk, and yes. Then we put in a pinch of salt. Mix it well. When you mix the salt and flour, any kind, try not to breathe the flour in, okay? You might have a sneezing effect or allergy. Now we have some, and we put in like half a cup of soy milk. And stir it and make it into a dough. If it's not enough, you can always put more soy milk. After mixing a little bit, you can add in another half a cup. A big cup, huh? And still can put more if you want. Huh? If you put too little, then the dough will be too hard. And too much as it be too soft. Too soft is better than too hard, okay? If it's wet a little bit, it's okay. Like this. Yeah? It's a little wet, it's okay. Okay, it's done. Now we're going to wrap a little bit of flour around the coconut. Hmm? Okay, you roll it a little into a bowl, yeah? And then you wrap it around the coconut. Leave the coconut sticking out a little bit, eh? Don't completely cover the coconut stick. Just wrap it around like this, roughly. It doesn't have to look so smooth. Yeah, make a thin layer around the coconut stick. So it will look like this, huh? Okay, look like this. Right. And we leave it aside. That's another one. Until you finish with all your coconut stick. Do you cover all your coconut stick? Yeah. You roll it into a more smooth ball and then press it flat. Press it flat with your finger. And no need to use any other instrument. This should be enough, okay? You cover it and press the edge together. It's still wet. It's better that your dough a little wet. Then you just press the edge together and then stick together. That's it. See, this is how it looks. Okay. See, this is good when a lot of people do it together, you know, like a couple of friends who came over. And you can teach them how, and they can do it with you. It's also fun. Yeah, okay. Your classmate come over and then you teach them how, impress them. They will love this. See, you can press it on the chopping board a little bit so it flatten out. Yeah? And even out a little bit and flat. So it flat out a little bit like that. Yeah. More even and flat. During the making, if you see that your dough doesn't stick too much together, then you add a little bit more soy milk, okay? Maybe your dough too dry. Yeah, you can wear a mask during the mixing of the flour, eh, if you want. The surgery mask, so that if you're allergic to flour, it won't go into your nose and make you sneeze or runny nose. Running eyes, yes. It's also good to protect yourself, you know, flour and those stuff, they don't belong to the nose, eh? So it's better you wear the mask when you handle flour or stuff. I think we prepare the salad now first, before we go into the hot dishes, yeah? Because the cold salad can stay cold very long. But the hot dishes should be eaten when it's warm, you know that, okay? So now we divide the avocado into two halves, yeah? Halve it. With the skin and all, yeah? Have to wash it first with the salty water already. Okay, we divide it like that. And we take the coral nut out. Okay, so that we have like 2 cups. You know, we can use a spoon, yeah, to scoop out the inner part, you know, the fleshy part, and leave the skin intact, yeah? So we can use it as a cup. Okay, gentle, yeah, like that, see? Okay, you can scoop a little bit more. Yeah, be gentle so that the skin outside will not be broken, because we want to use it. You know, less washing and nicer looking. Something exotic looking. When you put the salad inside this cup, look nicer, more natural, and save washing, save more environmental. Material, okay, like that. And we continue with the next. Scoop it out. There we are. Don't scoop too thin the skin, huh? It might break. You might dig a hole into the skin because the skin looks tough but it's delicate also and thin. We just leave a little bit to keep the cup standing well. A little bit of flesh in it to keep the cup standing. Right. Go gently just along the side of the shape of the avocado. Yeah? Just scoop it around like this, then it will come out easy. And take away the extra flesh that is still in there. Use a spoon, it's safer than using a knife. Because if we use a knife to scoop it out, we might injure the skin, and then we won't have the cup. Yeah? Just in case you make a hole into the skin. Not to worry. You use some aluminum foil to lay inside, yeah? If you don't want it to break. But it won't be any problem because this salad will not be so soupy. So even if you dig a little hole into the skin, very little things will happen. And even if a little sauce come out of the salad cook, it will go into the plate, yeah? You still can use it. There. So we have 4 cups. All clean, scoop out. Yeah. We're going to put the salad in there. First, we prepare the salad. Okay, we take away the hard nut in the middle of avocado, eh? We don't eat that, eh? You can plant it in a small little plastic cup until it germinates and sprouts. And then strong, you know, about this high, and then you can plant it in your garden and have plenty of avocado year after year. We have several avocado trees in my garden. Okay, now the flesh of avocado, you chop it into very fine pieces, yeah, small. You could even mash it as well, but I just chop it. You can mash it with the fork, no? Chop it into fine, because this is very soft actually. See, as I say, simple cooking, no? Simple cooking. I mean also using less utensil, because then you will have to wash a lot if you use all possible things. Then we have to wash, yes? Wasting time, energy. So, I'm a busy mom. I do the cooking simple. And I'm sure you kids are busy also, studying and passing out flyers, and talking to people, trying to make them vegetarian. Yeah, so we are very busy people. We don't have time. And don't make fun of the newcomer, you know? When they love to call this a spare ribs and all that, then it's okay, you know? They will get used to it slowly. They're not used to it. Yeah, whatever. Whatever means, bring them into vegetarianism is fine. Okay? Now we have the avocado chop already. We just sprinkle on top a little bit of the black pepper. A little salt. Good. Okay. And we have here lemon for my garden again. I will use this to squeeze it into my salad. You see, we already have chopped the thing on the chopping board, so I just put the lemon on it. We could also use a bowl to mix it, but in this case, it's all right like this. Simple, okay? Take the pulp out, eh? Otherwise, you get a surprise when you eat it, but it doesn't matter. The pulp of the lemon is also very good. And orange also very good, the pulp. Okay, this is a small lemon, so I squeeze them all in. Yes, one lemon. Good. You can put all this in a bowl to mix this better, okay? Yeah, I'm just very special. We can put fruity sugar or just squeeze a little bit of syrup on it. That's it. Very little bit. Okay. And then a little bit of olive oil. Like 1 tablespoon. Yeah. So remember, this is also organic olive oil for my garden. My little farm has plenty of things. We have avocados, peach, apples, grapes, kiwi, you know, you can plant beans and all that as well. We have nuts, walnut. Okay, mix them all together. Mix it together like that. And check if you like it. Wow, my God. So beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. If you want, you could even put a little coriander in it, you know, for zesty taste. If not, it's okay as is. Just get some coriander seed powder on it. Okay, and we're done. Now we can scoop this into your cup, né? Avocado cup. Yep, good, good. This is enough already. There's no need to have so many ingredients. That's enough. Tastes beautiful, actually. Okay, we put in the cup like that. Ah, look at that. Look at my avocado cup. How beautiful, yeah? Make it, fill it up, yeah? Okay, one after another. Wow, it looks so beautiful like that. Okay, so we're done like that. Make them all equal, otherwise you're guessing why you give one cup too many and one not enough. Like that, it's good, good. Okay, it's good cup, very good cup. Now wipe it a little bit, the edge, huh? With the kitchen towel, so make it look more tidy when you present it on the plate. There, there, wow. Mm. Tastes very good with lemon juice. You could, of course, use vinegar. Okay, and we have 4 cups like that now. Now we have to top it up with a little bit of a red bell pepper. Eh? Make it look good. Chop a few cubes of bell pepper and place it on top of your salad. Yeah, for the color. Yes. Yeah, good, good. Also can eat, of course, no? Yeah, like that. Okay. There we are. Look at your avocado salad. Yeah. This is how your avocado salad looks on a plate. Isn't it nice? It is nice, huh?
We enjoyed your company today for a gift of love, simple and nutritious cooking with Supreme Master Ching Hai. Please tune in next Sunday for part 2 featuring Cocoa Delight and exotic avocado salad. Good People, Good Works is up next right after Noteworthy News here on Supreme Master Television. Blessed be your noble and compassionate hearts.